The sun, the main source of life on Earth.
Why is the sun so important? It gives us energy. Plants use this energy to grow, and we use solar cells to convert energy from sunlight to electricity. How else can we harness the power of the sun?
One way we can harness the sun's power is through heat. We know that light from the sun carries energy to the earth. Because when you stand in the sun, you feel warmer. And when you leave things out in the sun,
oh no!
They can get hot.
We can use sunlight to make things even warmer if we either trap it or focus it. Let's look at ways we can trap sunlight.
Some ways are very old. Even hundreds of years ago, people used greenhouses to keep plants warm. A greenhouse is a building with big glass windows. Sunlight passes through the glass and heats up the plants and air inside. The hot air is trapped inside by the glass, so the plants stay warmer than if they were outside the greenhouse. Greenhouses were used by gardeners of the Roman Emperor Tiberius, so he could eat his favorite veggies year-round. And they're still used today.
We can use the same idea to build a solar oven, so you can cook using just sunlight. If you take a box, line it with aluminum foil, and cover the top with saran wrap, you've just made a solar oven. Light heats up your food through the saran wrap, and once inside, the heat is trapped. Mmm, delicious s'mores.
Unfortunately, this heating effect isn't always a good thing. On Earth, the atmosphere is like a window that lets sunlight in and then traps heat. When cars and factories pollute, it makes the window of the atmosphere thicker, so more heat gets trapped. This trapped heat is responsible for global warming, and the Earth is slowly getting warmer on average as we pollute more. Global warming melts glaciers and disrupts habitat. This is why it's so important that we pollute less going into the future.
Trapping sunlight is one way to harness the power of the sun. Another way is to focus it.
Here, sunlight is being focused with a lens. The illuminated water droplets show where the light is focused.
If you can take the energy of sunlight spread out over a large area and concentrate it onto a small area, you'll heat it up much more. Archimedes, an ancient Greek scientist, tried to use this principle to build a weapon to burn ships. He had many small mirrors which reflected sunlight onto a single point. That point was so hot that it could set wood on fire. It's debatable whether such a weapon would work with ancient technology, but it is a fascinating idea nonetheless.
We can use the same idea today to start a campfire. With a lens, light can be focused from a wide area to a small point. With all that sunlight focused on a small spot, the heat is enough to start a fire. Remember, kids, don't do this without an adult. Marshmallows! This same focusing idea is used in much more advanced technology today as well.
Instead of sunlight, a laser cutting machine generates a laser beam, which is another type of light, and focuses it to a tiny point in order to burn through material.
There are lots of other ways that you can use energy from sunlight besides trapping it or by focusing it to do something useful.
Can you think of any?